Hello, everyone, and welcome to the results show of the TGCTLive Olympic Design Competition. We've had 11 entries, all of them very, very good. We've played them all on their own individual shows, which you can go back on our YouTube channel and watch all of, if you so wish, or if you disagree with these results, which generally most people usually do.
Usually.
So today's show, we're going to run through the order of merit, starting from the bottom and working our way up to the top. We also have a few special awards for the individual courses, and then at the end we will play the winner. I'm Els41, broadcasting as usual from Harrogate in the UK. We have CrazyCanuck1985. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm good. I got off the golf course, had a little morning round of golf. I had a 52 on the front nine and then followed it up with a 40 on the back, so a little bit interesting. But it was
tackle two nines.
That is
no
different.
Kidding. Yeah, yeah, it was interesting.
And we have Dr. Yeti from Salt Lake City. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. My phone just buzzed. It is officially 100 degrees Fahrenheit in Utah today.
Ooh. Wow.
It is a scorcher.
Wow. If it was 100 over here, Britain would panic.
You would melt.
Yeah,
yes.
It really would be a disaster. Yeah. I'd quite like it, but it would be awful. Anyway, let's get on with the results. So let me bring up our lovely little presentation thing. Here it is.
Oh, Adam Hill 413 has spoiled it already. He heard the rumor that Littlebrook Manor won, and it did.
It did.
It did.
All right, that's the end of the show. Bye.
Show's over.
That's it.
People giving the game away. Welcome to all our chat room. I can see actually a lot of the designers are in there. S. Morris, Dr. Loden, Reeb, Scarpacci. The whole gang are in
Adam
there.
Hill.
Welcome along. Adam Hill, of course, who I noticed on the forum, his forum picture, have you seen it? It's him trying to take a sly over-the-shoulder selfie of Phil Mickelson.
Ooh.
It's very funny. It's very funny. I'm pretty sure Phil Mickelson will sue you if he sees that, but that's cool. You know, it's worth it, right? So let's get on with the awards. There are many. Go on.
I just pulled up his picture and it made me chuckle.
No, it is funny. Can I, were you saying something?
Oh, I'm just saying they're saying, oh yeah, Olympic branding. Yeah, hopefully the IOC isn't after us, isn't going to sue us after this show.
Yeah. Well, they did steal the brand from me, actually. That's a little known fact. So,
okay.
Yeah, did you know that? That's actually my logo that I invented for the Olympics.
I didn't realize.
Back in 19, or whenever it was. Anyway, so here's the judges' scores and how we scored it. Four main categories: hole design, playability, beauty, and fun factor. Each judge ranked our course from 1 to 11. Rankings were combined in the course with the lowest score was the winner. Pretty simple, right?
I think so.
So let's...
In other words, if you got a... we ordered them 1 to 15, or 1 to 11, excuse me. 1 to 11. If you were number 1 on Yeti's list, you got 1 point. If you were number 11 on Yeti's list, you got 11 points. Through Canuck and Els, and unfortunately CSU was got really tied up with life and was unable to judge all of the courses, so we scratched his scorecard completely.
Yeah.
The person with the lowest score wins. And what do they get?
And there we go. So let's and the winner will host the Olympic tournament, and for the winner, please four pin it immediately. So
yeah, we need it quick.
We need it like
soon.
Yeah, very soon.
Yeah. Yeah. We've left this a little late, so yeah. Anyway.
Yeah. And the winner will also win a $30 Steam, Xbox, or PS4
not
gift
and,
card.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because you probably don't have all three, but they never know.
We could give you 10, 10, and 10, but that would just make it a pain in the ass.
That really would be annoying.
Very much so.
Yeah. So, number 11 with 32 points. Highest individual finish was 10th, was Valentine Park from Adam Hill. Now, just because you finished 11th, same for the person who finishes 10, 9, 8, 7, it doesn't mean they were bad, because there really wasn't a bad one. And in some cases, even though it may look like there are points between them, there really weren't in some cases. In fact, for me, 11 to 8, I might as well have flipped a coin.
Yeah, we were really splitting hairs on a few anyway, especially in the middle, I found anyway.
Yeah. My out of the 40 points on my judging card, my lowest scoring course was a 28 and my highest scoring course was a 36. Yeah. So there wasn't even 8 point difference between last and first, and I had to then start splitting hairs between, okay, who tied at 32 out of 40? Who tied at 33 out of 40? It's so tough. All of them are so good.
And I definitely recommend if you're watching this and haven't played them, or if you entered the tournament and haven't played everyone else's, or if you're a someone who chooses courses for the web tour or challenge circuit or whatever, have a decent look at these, will you? Because they are all very well worth being on tour.
I honestly think each one of these is very worthy of having a tour spot at some point.
Yeah. So Valentine Park, I liked a lot about it. It had a lot of unique holes. There were some fairways at angles that made driving really tough, especially because there wasn't any light rough. I liked a lot of that because it's the Olympic course. It's supposed to be tricky, but I did find that 3 to 5 pins on it were almost unplayable even to pro level.
Yeah. I think it was those pins that actually cost it for me.
I think so.
Yeah, it's that, and yeah, the conditions, I think. Adam Hill is starting to get a name for himself of making just punishing courses. And for me, I think if you set them up right, firm, fast works well. But other times they can just be really frustrating. I'm not saying this was a bad course at all. I just think the conditions weren't quite, they weren't great for this setup. I think
they were probably on the wrong side of the happy, sad side of the way it could be set up. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that was Valentine Park at number 11. And by the way, you can go and play all these in one big tour. I'm sure it's in there somewhere.
I think so.
Number 10,
yeah, absolutely,
was Clay Bagel's Rio Morris GC, with the highest individual finish of 7th and ended up with 28 points. This was decent. This was actually one of the first ones we played. Actually, funny enough, both of them were two of the first ones that we played. There was a statue of Jesus, of which there were many.
Long course.
Yeah.
It was. It was long, and yeah, I found it was a little samey, kind of, a little bit. But it wasn't by no means it was a great effort. I did like the openness to it, but sometimes it was a little bit too wide open.
Yeah, I thought the design was, that was my main thing on it, was it was very nicely designed, tight fairways, tough landing areas, but I agree, it kind of got samey, a little bland at points.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, again, it's another one though, it's a great course, but just in context, there were some that really every hole was its own, almost its own work. Does that make sense? Whereas this, this one had some great holes, but some maybe that were a little more blending into the background. So maybe we didn't get the points that some of the others did, but still a really good course. And I remember this one being pretty difficult as well. I remember a lot of the bunkering being quite good and well placed in this one. So both of you said it was very long. Our first special award is for the best Christ the Redeemer, which has been won by Sam. Well done, Sam.
Well done,
You've made the best looking Jesus out of all of our all of our competitors. Well done.
What did he make it out of? I can't remember.
Wasn't it a great big tree?
And then the logs, I think.
Yeah.
Fallen logs.
Top quality Jesus.
It was very, very good. Jesus himself would be very proud of that, so well done.
He would be.
He also wins the award for the longest named course in the contest.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, Parque de Boa Vista Olimpico Golf Accurso, Rio 2016.
I don't know if that's a good or a bad award to win. Mr. Rula finished 9th, the highest individual finish of 8th. So this is an interesting one where actually a lot of our scores were very similar. And this one had a lot. We really liked the beach. A lot of the aesthetics around the course was very, very nice. Some of the golf itself was a little bit like the Adam Hill one. We said maybe just a little bit on the, oh my goodness, rescue me side. But again, a decent course, but in context of the competition, one that was just overtaken by some of the others.
Yeah, I agree. I think that was, this one was maybe one of the prettiest courses. But yeah, playability-wise, I found it was definitely lacking a little bit, but some really, really nice holes to look at. But yeah, I think, you know, yeah, same with conditions, similar to Valentine Park, like you were saying.
It was interesting because it was a very challenging course, but the greens were slow and receptive, and it was just so punishing if you missed at all. And your short game had to be spot on, or it just seemed like it really bit you hard.
Yep.
Number 8th, and it's our friend Sam again, with his highest individual finish of 6th, and 22 points. Sam's courses have a reputation, or they always have had, that he's kind of moving away from, of being always good, but a little bit on the fantasy side. I don't think this one was on the fantasy side, but it did seem to retain that madness, which is something that Sam has been known for, and that's I mean that as a compliment, actually. It's a well-designed, well-rooted, pretty course, which had a lot of challenges. I remember finding it quite difficult, and my score wasn't great. And a lot of the theming around the clubhouse and all that side of things were very, very nice.
Uh-huh.
But it was quite wild, which can be good, and again, can not be good.
I loved the whole layout. I thought it was very fun. There was some good shot shaping. The rock work was really nice. I dug the forested Rio look with the rock on the hillside. The variety of shots I liked a lot, but again, I think this one suffered a bit on the greens when I was scoring it.
Yeah, the greens have, you know, it's a huge part of the game. It's almost more than half of the game here because, you know, the other shots are so. It all comes down to the greens and, you know, really. Yeah, it's got to have that good mix of challenge and receptiveness, and you know, there's a bit of a struggle there. But you know what? I thought, like, his clubhouse stuff, like all those little tiny those points. I think he was one of the best courses out of all of them. But you know, that little eye candy's nice. But yeah, kind of comes down to, you know, how it plays. And it still plays very, very, very well. But again, it came down to the point, like.
Yeah,
we're getting into the sections here where I could flip a coin from about 8 to 4, to be honest. So
yeah. And Sam has actually said in the chat room there that it's already been picked up for a tour venue.
And
well deserved.
That's the real win, isn't it? And I'd be surprised if they're all not at some point. Maybe not this season, but next season for sure. Let's move on then. Number 7 was Boom Boom's. There was a disparity here because the highest finish was 4th. But Rio Vista Golf Club, I thought was very, very pretty. Great use of the theme. Great things like rock work and all the bridges were very pretty. It was a joy to play and look around as you were playing it. I think now, as Canuck said, I agree, we are starting to nitpick between a few of them. And I think there was just one or two things in this that made it a middle-of-the-road result rather than it being in the top or at the bottom. But they were just very, very, very minor things.
Yeah, I think this was kind of one, the three, one of us disagreed on. I won't lie, it's me. I had this a lot higher than you guys did. I loved this course. It was well receptive. It had some interesting, fun holes. It was probably the most fun course that I had on there. Kind of goes that way with all three of us judging. But seventh is still pretty good.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, great tropical course. I like the texture combo quite a bit. The planting and rock work were top-notch. Some of the rocks were a little big and not really covered or planted well. That didn't look too natural. The beaches were really, really nicely done on it. But this unfortunately got squished in the middle of my scorecard, where I have three courses that all got the exact same score and three other courses that got 1 point more. So, like, you know, we all said this is the split and hairs area.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think if you are in the next few places, it might as well say tied.
Yes.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Pretty much.
Number six is Scampi's Costa della Reina CDG. This is another one with a beach that made its way down the majority of the course. Another very, very good looking one. A decent, a lot of good use of things like the things that don't actually matter when it comes to the golf, like cart paths and the fences and all that sort of thing. But it was actually a very, very pretty course as well. I thought actually this one was one of the ones where the golf was up there with some of the best, and the golf does get the... That's what I scored it on at the end, was how good... Mm-hmm. Not how good a round I had, because otherwise they'd all be bottom, but how enjoyable and scary and adventurous the actual golf was. And there was a lot of very, very good holes in this, well rooted. The par threes were good. Yeah, I was a big fan of this one.
Yeah, this was another great, great, great course. Like you said, I think the golf, the golf in here was really good, but at the end of the day, it kind of just sunk into all these great courses, and I found it just didn't quite have enough to stand out among some of the more top courses. But
great attempt with the Delta theme. If not there being another Delta course in the contest, this would be one of my favorite Delta courses in the game. It's really good. I think, again, we're in this kind of midway tie on my scorecard. Probably, according to my notes here, the kicker for me that dropped it a little lower was the no light rough, and that's more of a personal preference.
Mm-hmm. Just having a quick look at some of our comments in the chat room. It's good to see that actually a lot of the designers are there. Good evening, Eddie Vedder. Welcome along. Mm-hmm. Fusion, good evening. Terry Grayson, good to have you all with us.
To the top five.
But first, the Alternative Olympic Venue Award, which goes to Boom Boom.
Yes. We got a comment on his pool that he built.
Yeah, the pool has two diving platforms. I believe it had actual podium next to it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Just well done. Just very creative.
This was a toss-up for me between Sam and Boom Boom, but we couldn't give Sam two awards, so...
what is it that Sam did as well?
He just his clubhouse.
Oh, and, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
His podium, his all that stuff was awesome.
On yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that picture on the left there from Rio?
I believe so.
Wow. Because we had, in London 2012, we had the velodrome, which was very nice. But that looks like something else. Mm-hmm. That looks very good.
No pee in Reeve Duke's pool.
Good.
Nice. And... Dr. Loden, or Dr. Loden, with Club Olimpico Rojina. Highest individual finish here was third, so it gained a top three from one of us. Had a road going down the side of it. This was also a delta, if I'm right. And I really liked the way that this was lit. I thought the bunker's placement and sculpting was excellent. I really like the use of water in this. I think it was one of the best use. Sometimes water can just be thrown in because you need something to put in a space, but this one actually felt like water was planned, really mm-hmm. planned. And I thought this was great. I really enjoyed this.
Yeah, amazing Delta courses. Yeah, this is one, like I just mentioned, on Parque de Boa Vista. No, excuse me, Costa de la Reina. One of my favorite Delta courses now in the game, and it's an extremely tough theme to design in. So well done. Good tight fairways, not too bad, good variety of holes. I feel like it was a little flat. I would like to see a little more elevation.
Yeah.
Elevation variety.
You guys pretty much said all I was going to say. I loved it. Another great Delta theme. It was just another one kind of like Scampi's that just didn't, it was, wasn't, didn't quite raise itself above, you know, some of the other top courses, but still very, very good course. And Dr. Loden's turned it into quite the excellent designer.
Definitely. It did get a top three vote from one of the judges.
It did.
Who is going to finish just outside the podium, guys?
Terry Grayson is. Now, this is a weird one in that he finished fourth, but his highest individual finish was fifth.
It's interesting because on our scorecard, we all gave him the five rating, all three of us.
Put him at fifth. And because other ratings were up and down, he actually finished fourth.
Yeah.
That's like the most crazy, weird TGCTLive logic ever.
That was a weird one.
But that's how it
works.
I looked
at that, I'm like, did we count that right? But, yeah.
But this was great.
I think he did the best sand and beach in the contest. The beaches looked amazing, and the bunkers, they were just staggering how good they looked. Good challenges if you missed on this course, too. But I felt like holes were set up for more risk-reward shots that weren't there. It seemed pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
Yep. I think he'd work really well with lighting and, like you said, sand traps and stuff like that. Very, very pretty course. Tropical is another theme that's just really tough to design in, and this is one of the better ones. And absolutely. I think Ibera did. I think that's the name of the actual Rio course. I think. Anyway, whatever. But yeah, great job, Terry.
Yeah, I think this is one of the best tropical courses in the whole game.
Mm-hmm.
All that we know of. There could be a great one hidden in amongst the nonsense. But this was, yeah, again, another one where water was just in the right place. You said it, guys, the bunkers and the design and the placement was excellent. The greens, I remember being huge on some of these. And, you know, if you're going to four pin it, you could probably about 10 pin this, couldn't you?
I
thought it was, yeah, really, really good. So, congratulations, Terry. We now have the I Do What I Want award, which has gone to Corey Creek by Reeb Doog.
We thought this was... Everyone seemed to either have, you know, worked in Delta or Tropical or had some Spanish-Portuguese name, but Reeb Doog just said, screw it, I'm just going to build a nice, quality, rustic course that doesn't look anything like you would find in Rio. And, we're giving that to. We could have given it to Adam Hill too, because he almost did the same with Valentin Park, because that one was, I think, Countryside.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, anyway, Reeb Doog does what he wants.
But we do know that Reeb Doog is in our top three.
We do. Who else is it? Could be in art.
So these are the medalists. If we're going with
these are the medals. So the bronze medal goes to Mr. Yates. P. Yates, who finished third with 10 points, had a highest individual finish of second, and Sandy Foot Links was something else. Looked good, played good, sand everywhere, rocks everywhere. Take your sun cream, take your little pina colada with an umbrella sticking out of it, and have a good old jolly good time.
Absolutely.
And probably score about 10 over par like I did.
Yeah, I loved the colours that he got out of the stones. He wasn't using... the rocks, he was using the stones, which have that brownish color, and then the dry grass just really made it pop to me. Had a really unique look and feel. What I really liked about this is there was some creative and fun tee shots, some very nice views. The approach shots had a nice variety to them. Just excellent. Well done.
Yeah. I think this was the nicest looking course of all of them, and that says a lot because all of these courses were excellent in terms of how they looked. But I think in terms of a kind of a unique look and feel, for me anyway, this one really stood out for me.
Yeah, this has got to be on a tour at some point. It was absolutely fantastic. Yes. Right, so the winner.
Yeah,
so,
yes, pause for dramatic effect. We're so, going to the winner now.
Terry Grayson has actually updated the chat room with it is between Antonio Scarpacci and Reeb Duke.
Yeah. So we're going to announce gold first, because otherwise all the suspense will die if we announce the second place first. However, there was so little between these two, really.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about the winner first, and then we'll talk about second place, and then we'll play winning course. So our winner is Mr. Scarpacci. Well done.
Yes.
With four points. With four That's points, right. Which means he obviously got two firsts and a second. With Bijo de Sete Cabejas, this was something else.
Yes, it was. Yes, it was.
Yeah, amazing course. Extremely well done layout. The planting was superb. There was lots of variety. It was good, fair challenge. I didn't feel like I was punished unless I made the mistake. It just an enjoyable course all the way through.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this was, it was the first hole alone. Just you knew you were in for a treat. And like Irving says, Scarpacci is one of these guys who, you know, can fart and make a great course. And
he's been doing it a long time. He has a huge list, and he just gets better and better and better. And I'm really looking forward to everything he keeps putting out.
Yeah, this is my favorite of his. And yeah, I think it's one of the best in the game right now.
Yeah.
I was going to say, Scarpacci actually entered a course in our very first par 3 design competition, the one that Yeti won. And if you look at that, and you look at this, it's almost like two different people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So, Scarpacci, you win, but you have some work to do now, because we need...
four pins.
We need four pins very quickly. So.
Yeah, like you have about an hour. Bye. Yeah.
No. A little more than an hour.
Yeah. Two.
Yeah, 2 hours. No, but ASAP is the truth. So you'll see this in a minute because we'll play it. But let's. We can't finish without talking about Reeb's course, which although we had a bit of a joke a minute ago and said that it, you know,
he seems
looked
to be the
nothing like
place.
All of the others. I mean, it's just an absolute stunner of a course.
Absolutely.
And this also got a first place from one of us.
And I'll admit to both Scarpacci, I did not give you the number one Scarpacci. I gave it to Reeb Duke.
Uh-huh.
I didn't feel like the course being out of theme, quote unquote, had anything to pull away that this is also an absolutely amazing course. Looking at them side by side, there's really nothing bad you can say about either course other than Scarpacci did just something a little better. And I think it was just, it's hard to describe.
Yeah.
They both are amazing courses.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. This course is, it just like some of the, it's just so fine tuned. It's just classic Reeb Duke. Some of these holes. Really the only thing that I thought needed a little bit of work, and I think I mentioned it on the stream, as I just thought it started a little slow, a couple of the holes it picked up, and there's like some of those holes are just outstanding. I can't remember, like 7 or 8 or something. It's my favorite hole in the game. It's awesome. But yeah, Reeb Duke is turning into the bridesmaid of TGCT design competitions. Yeti beat him in our par 3 contest, and now he finishes second to Scarpacci, but still excellent job.
Oh yeah, I mean, it is a winner, it is a medalist, it is a really, really good course. And yeah, throw the theme out the window, Reeb Duke's had and probably will continue to have, I'm pretty sure if you put his entire list of courses together that he's ever made, they will continuously be great. And the fact that you have finished second place all the time, when, you know, it's not been the same. You haven't finished second place to the same person every time. Do you know what I mean? You finished second place, and you've been that good every time.
Adam Hill saying he's the Lee Westwood of design.
Oh, that's not fair. It's true, but yeah. So let's play our winner, shall we?
Yes.
So if I get rid of this little picture, let's find our course.
So yeah, let us know, message us what kind of card you would like, Xbox, PS4, or Steam. I think if it's Steam, I can get it to them, but if it's an Xbox or PS4...
You have to go to me.
Yes, because... Yeah,
because America.
Yeah.
All right, just loading it up.
Me too. You'll notice I've got my Team GB outfit on today, seeing as it's the Olympic show. And did you realise, I didn't realise this, that actually it's the 27th of July, which is the date that the Olympic started in 2012. Right now we were sat watching the opening ceremony, which was still the best ever, I think.
Mr. Bean was there.
He was there.
He was there.
He was fingering a piano for a while.
He was. He was giving it a right good going.
I don't even remember the Vancouver opening ceremony.
Neither does anyone else.
Yeah. Apparently it was good.
Oh, yes.
I've got Doily joining me. Oh, wow, he's going to smash us all, isn't he?
I've already found the rough and the bunker.
Wow, how did you get so far ahead? I haven't even teed off yet.
Doosh,
and we're off.
I just teed off.
So who's our pick for the PGA, people? It does start tomorrow. It's weird having so many major tournaments so quickly.
Yeah, it is
weird. Like, it's... The majors are going to be over.
Yeah. There is Ryder Cup. But I think I'm going to pick RGS from Australia for this one. Just got a feeling.
See you, Reeb. I will jam a burrito in my nostrils. Burrito.
Yeah, thanks, Reeb. Thanks for entering. You know, great work, as always.
Ooh,
so I'm scrambling for a par here. You know, so I haven't really given much thought to who I think is going to win the PGA. I just didn't even realize it was this week until you mentioned it.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
I picked Henrik Stenson to win the Masters. It was two tournaments late. Or early, I mean.
True. What a fantastic win that was.
Those two were just... Him and Mickelson were just like... Were they playing like another course? Did they guys get to play the women's tees? Or like... I don't...
That was a fun round to watch, too.
Yeah, that was pretty impressive.
I just missed a 2-foot putt. Oh, yeah, look at this. I mean, the bunkers here are great.
Yeah. Bunkers and, like, the cart paths are immaculate.
I wish I had the patience to do cart paths like that. So, big question. I asked it last time, Canuck. How's the Pokemon Go going?
Oh, you know, it's Pokemon going.
Pokemon going, gone.
You're not walking into traffic blindly, are you?
No, I'm not. It's starting to lose its luster for me. It's fun, but, you know. It's kind of stupid, though, because my fiance is really still... She friggin' is obsessed with it. But
still,
oh yeah, but we accidentally joined opposite teams for our gyms, so we can't actually like team up to take a gym down, which is kind of
stupid. So are you red, blue, or yellow?
I'm yellow.
Yes, another yellow.
Which is,
that makes two of us.
Apparently they're terrible, or like, hey. I don't see any yellow, I just see all blue. You see the same?
Yeah, but I'm yellow. I'm kind of hoping when I go back when I go back to Watford during the week, bearing in mind we play in yellow, there'll be a few more yellows about.
Oh, fun. My boy just walked in. There may be a little Yeti on today's show.
Oh. Really? Maybe
that's
Yeti.
Not a euphemism, is it?
No, definitely not.
Well, he doesn't seem happy.
Oh, he doesn't. Actually, my wife just pulled him out of the room.
Oh, stop! Oh.
Stop rolling.
Oh, yeah, the other thing about this one, of course, is light rough is at a real, real premium, as I've just noticed.
And by premium, you mean there's none?
Well, there is some around the green, but there wasn't any on that fairway.
Oh.
Which fairway, on 3?
Yeah.
Yeah, I missed on that one and scrambled for a bogey there. But most of the holes have an option to lay up with a 3-wood. But that one, yeah, that one was a pretty long hole, so that one was a tough one.
Yeah. Oh, I see Doily, and now Tim has logged on and is playing this course at the same time. They're going to be judging our pick, I think.
Are they?
Sounds like it.
Well, if they disagree, then, you know, we have to question their authority, really, don't we?
Well, they're not allowed, because this was our job. They're not allowed to change it.
Yeah. Oh, why did that come back? Come on. That's a standard pitch, and there's more backspin on that than there are on most flop shots.
I just love some of these bunker shapes, and they're just like, some of them are just like really complex looking, others are just like simple. I don't know. The bunkering is outstanding on this course. Really? I really like it. Pops.
I am 3 over for 3 holes. Dreadful.
And the reddish tone in the sand looks really sharp too. That brownish reddish kind of.
See you, Sam. Thanks for watching.
Yep.
And thanks for another good course.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Uh-huh. Again, the community wins with all these, because it's not like these courses that didn't win get thrown to the wolves. I've already received, you know, messages from some of the course selectors saying, when are you doing this show? Because we want to put some of these courses on tour, and we can't until you guys have announced.
Could they not? So. Did we say that? We might.
Well, they didn't want to accidentally pick the winner. And then it hosts the Olympics, too.
Oh, then, yeah, fair enough, okay.
And it'd be obvious if we come in and say, wait, hold on, don't use that one.
Yeah, this is going to be a very, very good Olympic course, I think.
Reeb's par 3 course that came second to par 3 Paradise is on the 9-hole tour. I've already put it in. But it's your course this week. That should be fun. Yeti?
Yeah. It is the 9-hole Paradise week on the 9-hole challenge.
It is.
Oh, is the new week up?
Not yet. Friday.
Oh, okay. I'm struggling. I don't think I'm going to win. Or I don't think I'm going to make top 3, I mean, in my pool.
Get down there. Oh, just a little long. I played that hillside on the left of 6. And actually, no, it's getting down there. That worked out really nice.
So I can't exactly remember what the qualifying requirements are for the Olympics. I can't remember. I think it's like, depends on the country, but I think, from what I heard, 4 or 5 people from each country get to go, based on WGR. So...
What nationality is Ian Sweeney?
GB.
Oh, good, we might win.
You might. You probably will. Although, he did not have a great showing at the PGA Championship. And by not a great showing, he's tied for second.
Not a great showing. He's only winning by 10 points.
Yeah, no, he's tied for second. I might be in the top 15 of that tournament. I had a great tournament.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. after week 42, US and UK will have top 8. The rest will have max of 4. All right, so I will not be going to the Olympics.
Oh.
There are definitely 4 Canadians better than me. I don't want to get virtual Zika either, so I'm going to turn it down.
Yeah,
no, turn it down anyway.
Yeah, you've got a fiance to think about.
Exactly. We've been trying to look at places for our honeymoon, and that stupid virus has really cut down our options.
Where are your options then?
Well, pretty much anywhere in the Caribbean was kind of our plan. Mexico's okay. But we like to do stuff, so we're actually thinking we might do like a New York City, Boston.
Nice.
Yeah, do some touring around.
You wouldn't do like a Florida or Miami or something?
I don't know. I don't think so. We don't really like to just kind of sit around. We just want to get out and do stuff and see stuff. So,
come to Europe.
At first, we were thinking, you know, all inclusive, but now we're, thinking more like just visiting and seeing the sights. We thought about Europe.
Trip to the Mediterranean.
Yeah, we thought about those. Those are a little bit out of our price range right now. She really wants to go to like Greece and.
Nice.
Yeah.
Greece would be absolutely boiling hot right now.
Oh, that's very kind of you, Antonio Scarpacci.
What's he done now?
He's given the $30 gift card to us.
Oh, yeah. Well, you didn't have to do that. You did win. That's very nice of you, man.
Can that money be given back to the TGC Live team? Well, since it's our money,
it's
I don't
your.
Know. Yeah. Your guys' very generous donations means we have, you know, a fair bit of money in our little bank account, so we're going to start giving away some more things.
Yeah, for sure.
Probably lots of TGC tube codes.
Do you reckon, serious question. Okay, this is a semi-serious question. Do you think we should get, like, really weird t-shirts made with, like, our quotes on it or something? That'd be well funny. Give them away.
This is like a rag to wash their car.
No one would until you're like, you'd be watching something on the news and you see someone going on in the background going, hang on a minute. Is that? No.
He's got a shirt that says, need more lighthouses? Is that for real?
I would wear a TGC Tour shirt. Like a golf shirt.
Yeah.
Oh,
again, the bunkers here are great.
Yeah, they are just excellent.
Alright, so just sneak into even par through 8. Els, I'm showing you as a way for some reason.
Oh.
I had him as a way. Yeah, me too, actually.
But since I still see your ball
still got you live.
So chat room, since this is the Olympic stream, not counting golf, what is your favorite Olympic event to watch?
Ooh. I know.
What about you guys?
I like the sprint running and sprint swimming quite a bit. Like the 100 meter, the 200 meter, maybe the 400 meter. Anything longer than that, it's like, I can't watch a 3-minute race. I don't know.
Yeah.
But swimming too. I love watching that stuff.
Get in!
I also like watching the canoeing, the river canoeing. That's those guys.
Do you mean the rowing?
Talented. No, not rowing. Canoeing.
Like the whitewater rafting?
Kayaking.
Oh, yeah.
Not rafting. The whitewater. Yeah, that's cool. I like watching the obscure
said the women's
sports
beach
that you're like, that's an Olympic sport? Like skeet shooting. It's like, why is this on?
Archery is kind of interesting to watch. I usually don't end up watching it, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, I quite like... It's not my favorite to answer your question, but during 2012, I watched archery and, like, the clay pigeon shooting, which Britain actually won, and it was. I think I enjoyed it because actually it was. There was a British guy. I think it was an Indian guy, who was second from India.
Oh, Scarpacci, you are totally right. How could I forget women's beach volleyball?
Oh yeah.
Fair enough. Yeah. That's. you're just what am I? What is this? I'm distracted.
Yeah.
I think I do like rowing. Rowing's great.
Ping pong or table tennis. That's great.
Yeah, table tennis. That's fun. That's enjoyable to watch, just how quick and good those guys are and some of the saves they're able to make.
Yeah. I still remember last year, badminton, he brings up the thing. Last year with, what was it, Wimp Team Badminton or something? Wasn't like, I remember the Korean team all got... disqualified because they were throwing matches to set up easier opponents. So some of these matches were just like they were just like tossing and they wouldn't even go get it. And they threw all these matches. So eight teams got disqualified. And then all of a sudden this team from Canada who's not great all of a sudden moves up to third and they're in the bronze medal match. So what the hell? Everyone's going crazy.
I think I remember that.
Canada. Yeah.
That's ridiculous, isn't it?
Badminton's actually pretty big out here in Vancouver.
Come back. Is that where you play with your shuttlecock?
Play with the shuttlecock.
That's right.
Rhythmic gymnastics. Oh, there you go. Where you use the ribbon.
See, I don't like rhythmic gymnastics. I like gymnastics. The beam and the bars and...
The beam's good because he's one weird slip away from losing everything. And when I mean everything, I mean any future children. It's just one wrong move and you're done.
Yes. I like the steeplechase. I just don't understand why they have to jump over this thing and jump into water on the track.
And why doesn't the horse get the medal?
Oh, yeah. For equestrian? Yeah. You know, steeplechase is a running event.
Oh, wait, yeah, you're right.
Yeah, you mean, that's the one, though. So the dressage, how very British. We always do very well at that one. That's a sport we sit down at. That's why we do well. That's a weird one, because, I mean, it is very gracious and all that, but surely it's more to do with the horse than the person sat on it. Because if that horse doesn't want to jump over that pole, he's just not going to, is he?
No. My favorite and also the strangest combination of events is the modern pentathlon. Here's the five sports: fencing, 200 meter freestyle swimming, then they get on a horse and do show jumping, and then they do pistol shooting, and then a 3200 meter cross country run. That is an actual event. Those five sports.
It's like they picked them out of a hat, isn't it?
I don't know. I think it had something to do, hundreds of years ago, that those were the things people needed to do to survive.
Huh.
I don't know how show jumping found its way in there, but...
Prove you can ride a horse, maybe? I don't know.
I guess, yeah. But modern pentathlon. That's a sport.
Doesn't seem very modern.
No, it's the opposite of modern.
Terry Grayson, that was my child that was screaming in the background. Eddie Vedder, the top three are number one, Bicho de Sete Cabecas by Dr. Loden. Number two was Quarry Creek. By Antonio Scarpacci. Number one was Bicho de Sete by Antonio Scarpacci. Number two was Quarry Creek by Reeb Doog. And number three was Sandy Footy Lynx by P. Yates.
Yeah. Oh, what a horrible bounce. And it's gone.
Oh, yep. Terry Grayson got it in there, as I was saying. No worries. Thank you, Terry Grayson. Chicken plucking should be an event. Hot dog eating?
That would just be an American sweep.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if there was that Japanese guy that was, winning everything.
No, that's true. I saw Strav SCU up there put curling for a winter sport. Everyone's fascinated with curling, but here in Canada it's just a sport and it's on TV all the time and it's not interesting at all. But I see the appeal for people that have never seen it. It's just such a weird sport, and it's just mesmerizing.
It is so weird. Yeah.
Yeah. A friend of mine's actually one of the top curlers in all of Canada.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah. His team almost made it to, like, the big men's Canadian national tournament this year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Ooh, stop.
He's a professional curler. He's a teacher. And he's a stand-up comedian.
Is he good?
Yeah, he's quite good. He's actually right now at the Just for Laughs Festival in Montreal performing.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Olympic cornhole. Now, that's a game I could get behind.
Olympic cornhole?
Is cornhole a thing up in the Great White North?
Yes, it is.
Else, do you even know what we're talking about when we say cornhole?
No, it sounds rude, but that's fine.
Basically, it's a beanbag tossing game where you have two planks of wood with a hole in it set about 25 feet apart, and you take turns hucking a sack trying to get it in the hole. Hucking a sack full of corn.
Right. Yeah, that sounds like a very American thing. I'm not sure that would go down there. we should have some of the old Scottish events in, like tossing the caber and what's some of the other crazy events.
The Highland Games. Yeah. Isn't that what they're called?
Yeah, yeah, they're good fun.
Cornhole is usually enjoyed with a suitcase full of, like, Bud Light or Coors Light or whatever deep beer you prefer.
Nice.
And a suitcase being a 30-pack.
Suitcase, yes.
Does beer come in 30-packs in England?
If you buy 5 of them, yeah.
They come in 24 packs here.
Yeah, you can get 24 packs, yeah.
That's why we have a long weekend in May. It's Victoria Day, and it's usually around in the third week of May, and they call it the 2-4 weekend.
Hucking
nice.
A sack. Doing what to a sack? Hucking it. With an H. Huck. So, Els, if I came to Harrogate and used the term hucking a sack, they'd know immediately I was from America, wouldn't
you? You'd be asked to leave, probably.
Yeah, hucking a sack.
What are you doing? I'm hucking a sack right here, trying to get this sack in that hole. Keystone.
That's a horrible beer. We have that up here. It's usually at the back of the cooler.
Yeah, that's the Dirty 30 of Keystone that you drink when all the other beer's gone.
When there's no other choice, yeah.
There's not even water left.
What's your beers of choice, then? Of one chance. One beer left in the whole of the world, what would it be?
I haven't tried a lot of well-known world beers, but there's one brewed in, I believe, Pennsylvania called Yingling Lager.
Oh, yeah, I've had Yingling.
Phenomenal. That stuff's really good.
Yeah, I had that when I was in Orlando.
Very popular on the eastern side of the states.
Yeah.
But I've had to go with a local brew. There's one brewed right here in Utah called 801, which is our local area code, and it's a great local beer.
Nice.
That sounds good.
I'm quite enjoying...
Keystone isn't that bad.
Where I live in Yorkshire, there's a lot of very, very good microbreweries. There's a lot of there's like Leeds Pale and Black Sheep, which are ales. I quite like out of the States. There's this is it Sierra Nevada? That's nice.
They're a good brewery. They've got several good beers.
Yeah, I like those quite a lot. They've got a really nice Torpedo IPA, I think, which is really nice.
Yep, I think I love a good IPA. Sierra Nevada Pale Ale.
Yeah, that's nice.
If I've drank a lot of that stuff over the years. Uh-oh, I hope this isn't out of bounds.
There's a few like, really hipster bars in Leeds, which is so annoying. Leeds is the town next to Harrogate. It's so annoying, because you go in there and you get immediately attacked by an idiot with a man bun and a sculpted beard. It's like, oh yeah, I paid £5.40 a pint for this Sierra Nevada. It's just like, well, you're an idiot, aren't you? Cut your hair. I don't like hipsters. They annoy me.
I'm not going to lie. With my beer, I'm kind of like Man Bun Guy. I'm a bit of a beer snob.
Oh, I'm a beer snob, but there's a... You can be a beer snob and not be pretentious about it. Or, like, you know, wear braces.
Yeah. My favorite bar, there's one in Vancouver where it's, like, they've got 20 or 30 beers on tap, and they've got a screen of how much is left of each one, and the prices go up and down based on demand.
Oh, that's just like a stock machine. We have that here, yeah.
Yeah, it's cool.
Yeah, that is good. It's funny, because you can tell when that's in the pub, like, what your clientele is like, because all the beers will be really expensive, but it'd be like, wine? Free!
Yeah, pretty much, yeah. Budweiser, Corona.
Oh, Budweiser's horrible.
This weekend I tried hard root beer.
Is that any good?
Yeah, that it's actually quite tasty.
The Corona or Bust? I like Coronas.
Corona's good. Gotta have a lime, though. I don't think Coronas are drinkable without a lime for me.
See, I will drink it with a lime, but I prefer it without a lime.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I'm a limer. I'm not drinking it.
Ooh, who said Magnus Irish cider? That's a decent shout, although I actually really hate cider. But that's usually because it's too sweet for me. But, I never like the taste of cider. So.
There's a beer from Australia I quite like called Coopers, I think is what it's called. Coopers, give me a Cooper.
Yeah.
Coopers is good, and I occasionally will see that in the States every once in a while.
When I was in San Francisco last summer, they were really good. There were so many, like, obviously local beers, and they're all called, like, Golden Gate Bridge something, or Red Bridge this, or whatever. And a lot of them are actually really, really nice.
Mm-hmm. Thing that's funny is there's a lot of good beers out there, and I've had a lot of just shit.
craft
beer that is like, your microbrewery makes awful beer.
Yeah, Foster's tries too hard. Little microbrewery right actually in the suburbs here in Vancouver is called Red Racer. That's probably my favorite. They have a lot of good stuff. They come out with an advent calendar of beer in December. You buy it and you get a new beer each day up to Christmas.
Yeah, that's nice.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah. And they sell out immediately. I've yet to get my hands on one, but maybe this year.
Well, you two look like you're finished. I just teed off on 17, but we can start wrapping up the show if we want. Man, what a good course, though.
Oh, yeah. And you know, there were 11 good courses, weren't
they,
really?
Yes, there were.
And, you know, definitely play them all if you haven't yet. Reeves that came second, P. Yates that came third, Terry Grayson, you know, who was up there as well. All those are well worth going to play, and... we were very, very lucky, once again, with the quality of the entries into this competition. And I'm sure we will be back eventually with another one. We should be back next week with our regular shows, regular TGCT
Absolutely.
Live. So get your courses into us. You know, we're more than happy to have them on the show. I want to try and get doing some more designer specials as well. I'll get in contact with a few people, because that series, when we did that, went really well, and we maybe could do with a few more of those. But until then, once again, thank you all very much for watching. Thanks for all of our designers for submitting their courses. Thanks for everyone who's watched all of the YouTube videos, and you can go back and watch our playthroughs of all the courses. Still would be great to hear your thoughts, whether you agree with us, disagree with us, whatever. That's absolutely fine, and we will see you all again next week. Have a good week.
Thanks again, everyone.